Hey there too. What I got here for today is 2004 Mitsubishi Cult, and this is going to be full in depth drift the Cult. We'll set up, show the engine, go into some performance details, show you a bunch of the interesting features inside and out. And so, here's the key. Also, this car comes equipped with the aftermarket alarm, lock and lock. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while. Beautiful Japanese subcompact car. Very wide opening doors. As you can see, back windows are fully tinted. Rain guards. Two-ton interior. Seats are quite comfortable. Very nice. Three-spoke design wheel. This Mitsubishi Cult features hydraulic assist power steering, rocking pinion, very fluid. Manual tilt only to adjust just the slow right there. And right now, let's turn the headlight, high beam, front fog light, as well as the rear fog light, and hazard lights as usual. Driver side automatic down only window. And right now, let's open the hood and take a good look at the exterior of this car. Turn signal indicators and the fenders. 14-inch wheels. Tires measuring 175-65. Rear drum brakes. Mat flaps. Third brake light, and here's your antenna, rear defrosting glass, rear wiper. Very nice looking tail lights. Standard halogen headlamps, your fog light, This car has inline 4, 16 valve, 1.3 liter, natural aspirated engine. It produced 95 horsepower. Maximum speed of 180 km per hour. 0-6 time is 11 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 6.5 liter per 100 km. The car is front wheel drive. Rear fog light. And right now, guys, we'll take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. Two-tone door panels, storage, bottle holder, your speaker, power window lock, rest of your power windows. This car has four airbags, adjustable headrest and seatbelt, fully manual driver's seat, as well as passenger seat, sliding, sit high, recline right there. And right now, guys, let's see what kind of noise this little car produces. In this particular, has 82,175 kilometers in it at set temperature. very nice sound. Very easy to read cages. Aircraft and spoiler vans.
Power mirrors also heated, left and right. Huge mirrors, by the way. Nice, very nice.
Light indicator controls.
Have the headlights right there. Your intermittent wiper control. Build quality and all the materials are pretty cheap. You can find hard touch or storage.
Audio with MP3. Auxiliary right there. Little LCD display. 6 customizable station. Be checked. Different settings. AM, FM. Select between CD, auxiliary. Clock adjustment right there. Audio adjustment. Bass. Treble. Fader. Balance. Menu. Very easy to use. And language, English. Little storage right here. Very easy to use climate control, temperature, air conditioning, your fan speed, rear defrost, front defrost, so also different modes, and of course your recycle. Very nice. Your partlet, storage, 2 cup holders, automatic transmission, automatic mode, manual mode, plus and minus for the upshift and for the downshift, reverse, very easy to use, 2-stage heated seat, for the driver and of course for the passenger, high and low. Storage, your e-brake, very light, cup holder. Sadly, there is no central armrest. Seats are quite nice, thigh support is pretty good. Your map lights, manual dual rearview mirror for the aftermarket alarm, vent mirror, no illumination, and right there. Visibility is pretty good. Very nicely equipped, Japanese car. And right now, guys, let's shut her down. Let's grab the key and continue our store. Fuel cap release. And here's your fuel cap. As you can see, back seats easy to fold. Summer tires. Manual windows. Same two-tone. And the second row is quite roomy. Trunk is pretty small. But this trunk definitely suits your daily needs. Your illumination.
and you can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat, except seat height. Your glove compartment, motor size, your manuals, it's all Russian specification. Coin holder right there. Very nice looking Japanese car. And of course, fuel economy is just great. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2004 Mitsubishi Colt. Feel free to subscribe to my channel if you should catch me next time, so let me know where I came from. Thanks for watching and have a good one guys.